I said last night that he's not a guy for me that, you know, hits for average early on. He's always, it would appear to me, cold when the weather's cold. And then when the weather heats up, he's going to get his bat back and his groove back. Now, he had a grand slam the other night, I think last night or whatever. He has not played well. He has not hit well. He struck out a ton, and they're booing him. It's a perfect recipe for disaster. But you know as well as I do, he's going to hit 30-plus home runs and drive in around 90 to 110 RBIs. He's a 100 RBI guy last year, so 90 to 100 is, to me, a given. And it really is because he'll get 600-some at-bats, and I think that eventually he'll start, you know, just ripping the baseball, the cover off of it, and then go, you know, 2-for-4 every night, you know, or 3-for-5. He's going to get his couple hits every day in the summer, if you ask me. I'm with you. I think he'll come around. I don't think, you know, they'll ever be happy with him in Philly with the money that they gave him. They'll always, forevermore, every time the guy goes 0-for-4, they'll boo him and blame the money. Like, forever. It's going to happen for the next 13 years. Honestly, I think it's a death knell going to the Phillies. Because they're absolutely, in my opinion, unpleasable fans, right? So, and I mean it. Like, if you screw up, they just are on you every day, right? No matter what team you're on. Flyers, Eagles, Sixers, it don't matter.